Hi YouTube, I'm going to create a video on how to install Unbunto into VirtualBox. I had a friend ask me at work the other day how to do that. He wanted to know how to install Linux and beside a Windows OS, and I said, well, I'm going to make a video on how to do that, but first I'm going to make a video on just a basic install of Linux or Ubuntu. Basically, Linux makes Ubuntu, Mint, Slackle, Zorin, Netrunner. All these OS's are based off of Linux. And of course, you can purchase it if you don't want to download it, but download is totally free, and you can donate to them if you would like. But they offer all these out-of-the-box OS's here that you can download for free. And that being said, I'm going to put the link to this download in the description. And you can pick Mint is your basic Linux package. Ubuntu is the most popular. Okay. You'll go there and you'll click. I'm going to click Ubuntu because that's the one I'm going to download. And Ubuntu Desktop. Says thank you for downloading Ubuntu. Your download should start automatically. If it does not, click here. Boom. So I've already downloaded it and saved it in my ISOs, and here's where you can contribute with PayPal if you would like. Alright, we got the ISO downloaded. Now we're going to create it in the VirtualBox and name it Ubuntu. This is the newest version of Ubuntu 18. I'm going to just name it. Ubuntu 64-bit. Next, here I'm going to just, I think I'm going to get 2 gigabytes. 2 gigabytes of RAM. Makes it run a little faster. This is just pretty cut and dry. You just next, okay, and next. Here you can change the size of the hard drive if you would like. If you're going to use it quite a bit, I would suggest you going to maybe 20 or 30 gigabytes if you have the extra room. I have 2 terabytes, but I'm just going to leave it at 10 because I'm probably not going to do a whole lot with it other than for demonstration purposes. And there you have it. You click start, and this is where you have to install your ISO. After you click start right here, your host drive, that will be like a CD drive in VirtualBox. It's your virtual CD drive. And so you click the little folder and locate the ISO you just downloaded. You can save it to your desktop or wherever you saved it to, that's where you want to select it. Click open and start. And there she goes, booting up. Over here tells you the activity. It's see the CD is spinning. That means it's reading, like it's reading from a disk. This here is like your hard drive flickering. And here is the option where you can try Ubuntu or install Ubuntu. Click install, because that's what we want to do, is we want to install it. If you just try it, it's only good until you shut it off and then it's gone. installation and download updates while it's, you want to leave this checked if you're using it, but I'm going to uncheck it because I just want to hurry up and install it for now. And here you'll erase the disk and install Unbunto. You just basically don't change a whole lot here. You just kind of go. Next and continue. Pick your time zone. I'm not in Chicago, but I'm in the same time zone, so I'm going to leave that where it's at. Click continue. Time or name this test. And put in my password. And I'm going to make it log in automatically. This part takes a while, so I'm going to pause the video and just let it do its thing here. You know what? I'll let it run. It don't take that long. I'm going to go use the restroom while it's running. You can too, or get you something to drink. Okay, I'm back. Now you may be asking, why would anybody want to install this into a virtual machine to begin with, or into a virtual box? It's a virtual machine and a virtual box are basically the same thing, just different versions of the same kind of software. But my friend at work was asking me, he was asking how could he install Linux on his computer, and he was going to go and buy another hard drive and install his hard drive into his PC and then get Linux and install it onto that separate hard drive. And I said, well, you have a couple different options. You can run Linux beside Windows on your hard drive, or you can install it in a virtual box. And he kind of looked at me funny when I said virtual box, I just assumed he knew what it was, but apparently he didn't. So here, this is kind of a safe way to do things on your PC if you want to test different operating systems, freeware, different things you can test as far as any software you can test inside a virtual box, and it will not affect your host machine, which is your personal computer. It writes everything, stays inside the virtual box or virtual machine, and you don't have to worry about something crazy happening to your own PC because it all stays inside the virtual box. Therefore, people use it for testing virus, antivirus software against malware and viruses and such things as that, or developers use them, I'm sure, virtual machines to test new software they've developed or what have you. You know, it's pretty handy. It's fun for me. It's kind of geeky to tinker around with, and I'm trying to make more videos on YouTube for you guys that are subscribers. And if you're not subscribed, by the way, go down there and click the subscribe button while you're waiting on this installation to complete, and that way you'll be alerted with all my new videos that I post in the future. Almost done, just a few more minutes. I figured I'd let it run, because if you're doing it, I know I've installed things in the past and I think, well, is it hung up? Or is it supposed to be doing something? Well, if you have a video to go by, you can tell where mine has made it to and how long it's taken to go. And always, if you don't want to watch it, you can fast forward to the next part after the installation is completed. I've got a few more things to show you here in just a second. Preparing to complete, removing files that it took to install it. Looks like it's going to be pretty cool looking OS, the new Unbunto. And they have all kind of help right there, as you can see. You can ask the community if you have problems or questions. Change the appearance, customization. It comes now with LibreOffice installed already inside the OS. That's Libre is a powerful, powerful office program as well. I believe it's better than Microsoft Office. The problem is not everything's compatible. Most everything is, but not everything. I've run into a few small issues with some of software that would use Microsoft Office that wouldn't work. Not many, but a few. Skip button here is just for like skipping certain parts of the installation. It'll only allow you to skip when it's highlighted. As you can see right there, it wouldn't even let me click it if I wanted to, but I don't recommend doing it. But if there is something you don't need to install, you might as well skip it. Is complete. You need to restart the computer in order to use the new installation. Restart now. Boom. Please remove the installation menu and press enter. That's right here in the optical drives. Let's go ahead. Oops. Start, everything will be fine. But when you stop the when you shut down the machine, you can go into your settings and remove those ISOs. This has an ISO from where I installed Ubuntu 14 earlier that I Also, I don't know why this microphone has such interference in it. I don't know if y'all can hear that. Look at this, it's so neat. Oh man, I may just switch to using Linux. Done for now. I'm not ready to use any of that. And there you go. There's your LibreOffice writer, RhythmBox. Amazon's already preloaded in it. This new Ubuntu is slick now. Thunderbird Mail. Let's see if Mozilla will open up here. Firefox. I'm sure it will. It says I'm connected, right? You can move this bar too to the bottom or top, wherever you want to move it if you right click it, I believe. There's Firefox opening up. You can see how it's kind of sluggish. I'm glad I put the 2 gig of RAM. It wouldn't hurt to put a little more, but I'm not going to use it that much, I don't think. And here you can sign into your Firefox account. It's already down. I've got Firefox built in it. Let's see. Oops, I think I spelled it. Linux.org, and there's your Linux homepage. It's up and running. There you have it, guys. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe my videos, and we'll see you later.